students, I am Dr. Anandi. Welcome to my channel Make Biology Simple. In today's video we are going to see the enzymes chapter lecture 4, that is nothing but active site. So we have seen in a series of lectures about the enzymes, substrate, enzyme substrate complex, isoenzymes and the kinetics of enzymes. So today we are going to see about the active site. So active site is nothing but the place where the exact substrate goes and bind and the modification takes place. So that is the position. See, for example, this is an enzyme. Here this portion or the pocket or the groove where your substrate will come and bind. So this is a site where the enzymes, this is a site where the substrate binds. So that site is called active site. Active site is defined as the small region at which the substrate binds and participates in the catalysis. So here only this, I told you, this O3 reaction, either an oxidoreductase type or a transferase type, hydrolysis type or isomerases, ligases or lyases. So all type of reactions will take place only in this site. So that is why it is called active site. So now we are moving to what are the salient features of the active sites. So what is the nature of active site, how it is activated and what it's doing, all this information is giving under the salient features of the active site. Now the first point is the existence of active site is due to the tertiary structure of protein resulting in three-dimensional native conformation. So this point defines that since the enzyme is a protein in nature, yeah, and it holds a tertiary structure. Tertiary structure means it can bend and it forms any way it can fold and form the structure. So why this point is very particular means, so that's why it makes the amino acid from wherever, not in a series like for 1, 2, 3 amino acids. It may be from different positions of the amino acids due to the folding can make a point of the groove or the pocket where the amino acids from the different locations of the protein come and join. So for example, so here we are given the example as a lysozyme. So lysozyme is an enzyme which contain 129 amino acids. Among the 129 amino acids, see this 35, 52, 62, 63, 101. So what are these? These are the amino acids numbering in the protein in the enzyme called lysozymes. So only these 35th amino acid, 52nd amino acid, 62nd amino acid, 63rd amino acid and 101 amino acids. These 5 amino acids, when they are form a tertiary structure, they come and they can form in the site, that is active site. Particularly it is occupied by these number of amino acids in the case of lysozyme. So that is what it means here. The active site is made up of amino acids which are far from each other in a linear structure. That's what it's given. For example, in the lysozyme, if you count the number of amino acids starting from 1 to 29, if they are straight, they are not able to come in this like this in this position, that is in the pocket like this. So suppose if the amino acids are taking the tertiary structure, that means bending and folding as in the way, what happened? The linear amino acids, for example, 35, 52, 62, 63, these are coming in contact here. They are coming in close proximity only in this site. So this is because of the possibility of the tertiary structure. So this, that is what it means, that the active site is formed by the contribution of amino acid residues number 635, 62, 63 and 101. So these are the one, the third point is relevant to the second one. These are the points where the clumps or grooves or the pockets occupy a small region in the big enzyme molecule. Say for example, see this is a big enzyme. Under the big enzyme, you can see a small portion is taking a curve. So that type is called, that position is called active site. And the fourth point is, it is not a rigid in structure and shape. It is flexible to promote the specific substrate binding. So the first thing we have seen, the how the protein has undergone the changes and make the different position of the amino acids to form a pocket called active site here. The next thing is this position, this active site is not rigid or not very stable, and they are very flexible. So why it is flexible means accordingly, so that the substrates can bind and it can undergo changes. That means catalysis can occur. So that is what the fourth salient feature of the active site explained. The fifth point is the active site possesses a substrate binding site and a catalytic site. So the latter is for the catalysis of the specific function. So the active site, it not only holds the substrate binding, but it is also undergoing the catalysis. Catalysis means, as we know very well, oxidoreductase type or a specific transferase, isomerases, ligases, lyases, hydrolases. So all these reactions are happen in only in this site. So they contribute not only for substrate binding, for also the catalysis. So that is what the meaning of the fifth point. Next, the sixth point is the active site. Here you can see the coenzyme as cofactors on which some enzymes depend or present at the part of catalytic site. Of course, we know that these changes which undergo in the Othell reaction, so some of the exchange of hydrogen, oxygen, water molecule, transfer of the functional groups, whatever may be. So all these have to be depend upon the coenzyme and cofactor. So of course, this coenzyme cofactor should also present in the catalytic site, because the catalytic site is the position where the catalysis occur and undergo the changes of a substrate to a product formation. The seventh point in the active site is the substrates bind in the active site by weak non-covalent bonds. Why they are called weak non-covalent bonds means that is why the substrate, once it is undergo some changes, has to be converted to product. So once it is converted into product, it has to leave the enzyme. Then the product come and the enzymes will be separated. So that's why the substrate binds in the active site belongs to weak and non-covalent bonds. So weak and non-covalent bond in mean that it, after the product formation, it has to leave the enzyme. That's why it is non-covalent. And the eighth point is enzymes are specific in their function due to the existence of the active sites. So this active site is very specific to the particular substrate. That means one enzyme, one substrate concept. So one enzyme, one substrate, they are specific to. We have seen the glucose is very specific to glucokinase, but the glucose is not specific to hexokinase. Why? Because of this existence of the active site. So that's why each enzymes are specific to one particular substrate. And the ninth point is, we have seen some active sites are made up of some particular amino acids. What are the particular amino acids which present in the active site? They are serine, aspartate, histidine, cysteine, lysine, arginine, glutamate, tyrosine. So these are the most of the amino acids which is present in the active site. So what type of amino acids belong to this groups are nothing but they may be a hydroxyl group amino acid, sulfur containing amino acid, basic amino acid, and of course acidic amino acids. Lysine, arginine are basic amino acids. Glutamate is a acidic amino acid. Tyrosine is a hydroxyl amino acid. So you can see the COOH, NH2, OH, SH group belong, which is mostly present in these amino acids, will able to undergo some transformation in the reactions and will help the cofactors and coenzymes to help to undergo these changes in the substrate to the product formation. So that's why they are very specific of some of the amino acids. These amino acids should present in the active site. And the last point about the active site is, the substrates binds the enzyme at the active site to form ES complex. The product is released after the catalysis and the enzyme is available for reuse. This is the general concept about any reaction. For example, enzyme will combine with the substrate at the active site and undergo some changes when it is in the ES form. ES means enzyme substrate complex form. And once the undergoes some changes, now it has to be converted to enzyme and product. So this product should come out from the ES complex. That means no more ES, now the enzyme product has been formed. So that's why we know that this weak non-covalent bonds, when their active sites bind or belong to the weak non-covalent bond along with the substrate only, it can easily come out of the enzyme. So now once a formation of a product is there, no more it is yeast. Now it is converted to ghee and product. So now the enzyme will come out and product is released. So now the product is existed out. So what happened to this enzyme? The enzyme again it is reused for another reaction. So this is a general concept of any type of particular reaction. So the active site is the one in the whole enzyme protein structure. The active site is the one which do undergo so much of changes and involved in the product formation. So we have seen our active site is a pocket or a grease or a groove where the particular substrate will come and bind, and they have some particular amino acids belong to the hydroxyl group, sulfur containing and basic amino acids, acidic amino acid groups. All these will favor the transformation or the changes in the O2L type of reaction, and also favors the coenzyme and the cofactors to undergo the changes. So that's all about the active sites, the salient features. I hope this will be very easy and understandable manner, and we'll continue with the next lecture about the enzymes in the next video. Thank you, students.